So now we're going to talk about MEMS gyro. MEMS gyro is the one type of sensor that in a way enable those things to fly without bumping into walls too much or without the need to have a very good pilot or operator to operate them. A MEMS gyro in a way allows me to stabilize my drone, my camera drone, and lots of other things. In order to keep things simple, remember that phrase. A gyro is a sensor for sensing angular velocity. Let's demonstrate that. It won't be too complicated. We need a graphic demonstration. We see here a bunch of lines, and I'm holding the phone relatively vertical. And now I'm rotating. I will do that. Yeah, you can see that now when I'm rotating, the green line, we're doing like crazy downwards, and let's do it the other way around. So now I'm counterclockwise. So obviously the green line represents my movement. Its area represents the entire change, and its height is the actual velocity. Again, the height of the green line at any certain point is the angular velocity according, on that manner. Clockwise would be, minus, and anti-clockwise or counterclockwise would be positive. Let's do that same thing with the phone, in a horizontal manner. So again, I'm doing the same movements, and I can see the same thing with clockwise and anti-clockwise. Now we're going to do a field experiment. Well, not really a field experiment, but I want us to feel what happened when a drone is moving, say, clockwise in a slow pace, and then fast enough want to do a counterclockwise, and at the end of the day, it want to remain in the same orientation. So let's do a physical experiment. First, I'm gonna move the phone in a slow pace, 360 degree, let's do that. So now, relatively slow pace, and I'm moving it, 360. So this was clockwise, now counterclockwise, but in a fast pace. Right, you see those two areas, one below the x-axis and one above. They have the same area. The area represents the movement or the change in the angular. But the first one, the clockwise, the slow one, took me more time. The other one, the counterclockwise, was faster, so less time. But the area is the same. The area represents the movement, the change in movement. The actual sensing is the velocity. Again, consider you're driving 50 miles per hour, 80 kilometers per hour. If you're driving for 1 hour, well, on average, a speed of 80 kilometers per hour, you would do about 80 kilometers. The same thing happened here. I have an angular speed. The angular speed allow me with the gyro to detect the velocity, the angular velocity. So consider the a clock. The angular velocity of the second dial will be about 360 degrees a minute. So why are gyros so important for drones? They are extremely important for them for their stability. So consider a drone, this tiny drone. It's very sensitive to wind. So assuming it needs to go forward and there's some wind pushing it, maybe turning it that way, or maybe that prop is ruined for some reason. Having a gyro allow it to understand that tiny angular movement and fix it. This is extremely important for stabilize the camera. So the drone is moving because of the wind and vibration, who knows? And this little camera here has an IMU or a gyro on it that allows those little tiny motors to fix it. Right, so gyro is a nice, very helpful sensor. extremely widely used on those remote controls and in drones and the other toy-like stuff. But it has one drawback, important drawback. While an accelerometer might be not as accurate, it never drifts. The gravity forced me downwards. While a clock is drifting, you might, fix your clock today, come in a few hours or a few days or a few years, and have it drift maybe, a few hours forward or a few seconds backwards, doesn't really matter. But the fact that a gyro or a clock drifts is extremely important to keep in mind, because the longer I wait, same with the clock, the more drift I have. So the camera using the gyro and the tiny little motors can collaborate itself and can align itself and can stabilize itself very well. But after a long period of time, a drone using only a gyro would do those movement and fixes all the time, and along that period of time would drift exactly in the same manner that a clock would drift. And those drifts are here to stay as long as you are using only gyros. In order to fix that drift, we need a global sensor or another sensor that has no drift property. And that sensor is a compass.